I'm here with Chef Morlon. So today, I hear I'm gonna have some snapper, Florida.
Local Florida yellowtail.
Excellent.
We lightly marinated it with some fresh thime, some crushed pepper. Now we're gonna simply pan sear that.
Let's get started.
Shall we? So here we have some olive oil.
Yes.
Pan's nice and smoky hot. Now we're just gonna lightly season our fish, a little bit of salt, skin side down.
Yeah, so only that side has been cooked. You're not touching the top.
Correct.
The fish is moving nicely, so it's going in the oven. Time for the sauce?
Absolutely. Could you pass me the olive oil, please?
Yes, sir. How much?
Perfect.
Perfect, he said.
I feel like you've been cooking your whole life.
I have.
So we have the fregola, basically an Italian couscous. It's been toasted to get a nice nutty flavor out of it. Now we're going to have a fricassee of vegetables. So we have some baby carrot, fennel for some sweetness.
Fennel, I love fennel.
Onion, we're going to quickly saute that together. And now we're going to add the fregola. Just let that warm through.
Yes. It's going to have a little alcohol, maybe?
Of course.
Ah.
What would be food without a little bit of alcohol?
Alcohol, butter, whatever.
Now we season that up with a little bit of espalette again and salt.
Lovely. He's very big on this. Woo!
And I think we're ready to deglaze. So here we have some dry vermouth right in there. Now we're gonna deglaze with the Aperno. Wonderful anise flavor, but it's very strong.
Oh yeah, I love this.
So we're just gonna put a touch of that in there.
Let's have a little more.
Why not? There you go. Smell that beautiful aromatic coming out of that.
Yes, gorgeous. Pan. Very creative. Just double checking him on the seasoning. You could get drunk on this.
Off the heat, we're gonna add a touch of lemon juice.
I love this. This is a dish alone.
It's gonna complement the snapper wonderfully.
Fabulous.
And that's ready to go. I have a puree of artichoke.
Okay, for garnish?
Correct. That's gonna go on the bottom of the plate, nice, moussey.
How's our poor little fish? Now, how long do you like to have it in the oven?
For a fish about this size, roughly 5 to 10 at the most. You still want it to be nice and opaque in the center, as you can see. Beautiful crispy skin on the other side.
Gorgeous.
Still almost medium in temperature. Yep. So now we're gonna rest our fish.
Right.
A nice roasted root vegetable in the rutabaga. So this is gonna add a wonderful vinegar element.
Adds a little acidity. Very posh.
Nice golden caramelization on there.
Excellent.
We're gonna deglaze with some sherry vinegar.
Now we've got sherry. He's got so much alcohol back here.
The salsify is gonna pick up all those flavors.
Yes.
And then we're gonna add some dark chicken stock, reduce it down until it's nice and tender. When we're all finished, this is what it's gonna look like. Beautifully glazed.
Oh my God, that smells incredible. It's assembly time, let's go.
So here we have our beautiful puree.
It's very complex.
We have that wonderful salsify, and that natural jus that we made, the reduction of that. Here we have our fricassee of fregola.
Let me just check it. See, it's still as good.
Check that seasoning, please. And here we have a beautiful emulsion of mushroom, fennel, and artichoke. Now we're not foaming it, we just want to breathe some air into it. And here we have our crisp snapper.
Pretty dish.
Foam around just to tie everything together. Some micro basil, some amaranth.
Lovely. That's going on fish, final garnish.
Exactly. Bon appetit.
Bravo. Well, I've got to try this vegetable first. Rutabaga. These vegetables are outstanding. They stand alone. It's time for the fish. Historic.